Okay, so if you noticed from the video, it's pretty interesting that what may look like total chaos if someone just walked in the room is actually quite organized for us. Everything's in little piles and we know exactly where everything is. We had little piles of CDs, piles of books in another area, piles of computer equipment in another part. Piles of magazines and catalogs, which are different from books, so they get pushed out of the way somewhere else. Paper, artwork, and instruments were all piled on top of the table, and so on. So we know exactly where everything is. It may look disorderly, but for us it works. And this is something that messy INTJs have in common with most INTPs, is that it's not hurting anyone, it's not bothering anybody, so all these piles are technically invisible. It's not until they get to the point that they're in the way that we can no longer ignore them that's when we start to clean up. We just can't take it anymore if the piles are, going into our walkways and we can no longer walk, then that's time to finally start cleaning the house. An S type would be appalled by this. An S type would be like, get all this stuff off the floor, put it on the shelves, clean up the mess. But for us, it's like, we know where everything is, it's not hurting anybody, it can stay there for another week or month or whatever. Going back now to the point that the J types like, do not like open-endedness, and it's very true of me. I don't like books and movies where it leaves the ending to the imagination. That type of thing just irks me so much. I had a friend one time recommend that I should read the author Lovecraft because I like monsters and science fiction mixed together. So I picked up a collection of his works, and the first story was At the Mountains of Madness. That book started off wonderfully. Great descriptions. Very accurately scientific for its time, how it had worked the science in with the fiction and the mythology. But when it got to the end, the main character refused to describe the monster, saying that it was too horrible for human eyes and that no man should ever know of what horrors were really there. And that's how the book ended. And I was like, what the hell? That's the whole point of why I was reading the book about to learn about this monster. And I read the other short stories in the book, and it was all the same thing, great build-up, but the end was ruined because he was too frightened or couldn't finish the book the way it should have been and told you what it was about. So yes, for me, a movie or a book can be ruined by the ending. It can be have a perfect, wonderful start, but if you screw up the end, the whole thing's goes in the garbage for me. That kind of thing really bothers me. And because I'm such a final person in the things I do and the things I say, I know that the majority of people have a hard time dealing with someone like me because people like to hear what they want to hear, not what they need to be told. And the way I deal with my friends, anybody actually, even people I work with, is I tell them the truth and what they need to hear, not what they want to hear, because later on the truth's going to come back to bite them and they're going to be sorry that they didn't know. And I respect my friendships too much to lie to my friends and to tell them that it's going to be okay when it's not. I'd rather tell them how to deal with the problem and how to prepare for what's coming than to sugarcoat it and make something up. So that's another quality that I have that's definitely J for me. And the people that are that I consider my good friends, my true friends, accept this and appreciate this. They wouldn't want me to butter things up and sugarcoat and lie to them, especially when they ask me for their advice. Or when they ask for my advice, I mean. Yeah, I respect them too much to treat them any other way, and I expect the same thing in return from them as well. We Jays are also doers. We like to work with things and again, reach an accomplishment with it, whereas Ps are more theoretical. They like to think about a topic, but to actually see it to completion, they would probably hand it over to a J type, and we would enjoy working on it, especially if it's something that we hadn't thought of before, coming at a problem from a different point of view. The most important thing for us INTJs is, yeah, it is true, we are fairly open-minded. The main thing is, does it work though? If you give us an idea and we think it's not gonna work, or we know it's not gonna work because we've tried it before, then we'll think it's stupid and ridiculous and chuck it out the window. Well, I guess that's about it for now for having dealt with the four axes. I can't think of anything else to say about J's, but I do want to talk now about some of the funny interactions I've had with my S friends. Sometimes when I take the Myers-Briggs test, there have been a few that I come up as ISTJ, and I'm definitely not an ISTJ, but I do value some of the qualities like following the rules and enforcing the rules, which is probably why I get inaccurate test results. I usually tell people that you shouldn't put too much stock in the answer you get in the test. If you think of any of the four axes might not be true of you, that the best thing to do is to research the material and decide for yourself what is true of you and which personality fits you best. And I used to worry about this when I first got into Myers-Briggs that, oh my gosh, I tested as an S, but as the more I've read and the more I've gone through life and made my decisions, I've realized that no, I am not an S. And there was a perfect example that a friend of mine came over for give me a birthday gift, and I think she's ESXP. I haven't figured her out quite yet. She's definitely extrovert, so I can never get a hold of her because she's always out. But she came over and she brought me these napkins and placeholders and little plates and everything. And I don't have a table yet for furniture. And one of the first things she asked me was, "Oh, have you been decorating?" And that question to me was just so alien and out there that I never even considered decorating. No, I hadn't even thought about that. I'm still working on, getting essentials in, functional things, and maybe later I'll worry about appearance and, things like that, decorating. But I thought that was so funny, and that she realized that she probably would have had to have gotten me a different gift and buying me things for furniture that I didn't have yet. And because we're quiet, INTJs seem to make very good ears whether we want to be or not. People tend to come to us with problems and ask for advice. This happens to me quite often, sometimes from total strangers. And again, what bothers me the most is when I give my advice and people don't act on it. But it's true, we are very good listeners and a shoulder to cry on when people need help. I don't know why. Probably because we're introverted and we're not going to be sitting there talking back until the person is done, and then we can help out and give advice. I think that because of our intuition, we can also give advice on situations that we have no experience in, because once again, it's pretty clear cut for us which is the right choice and which is the wrong choice and what people need to do. So yeah, it kind of makes sense that others would come to us with their problems and or just need someone to listen to them. Okay, I think I'm gonna stop here for now because I seem to be rambling and I've pretty much covered everything that of what it's like for me on my 4 points as an INTJ. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed this and maybe later on if I think of other topics to talk about involving Myers-Briggs or interesting situations I've had happen to me, then I'll put them up. Bye bye.